In this video, I am discussing Unit 5 CAMS and Followers in the subject Mechanics of Machine. Question number 1, define the following terms. These are very important, very important for your examination point of view for 5 marks. First one is base circle, second one is pitch circle, third one is pressure angle, number 4th stroke of the follower, and number 5 trace point. The first one is base circle. It is the smallest circle that can be drawn to the CAM profile. Second one is pitch circle. It is a circle drawn from the center of the CAM through the pitch points. And third point, pressure angle. It is the angle between the direction of the follower motion and normal to the pitch curve. This angle is very important in designing CAM profile. If the pressure angle too large, a reciprocating follower will jam in its bearing. Number 4, lift or stroke. It is the maximum travel of the follower from its lowest position to the topmost position. Number 5, trace point. It is a reference point on the follower and is used to generate a pitch curve. In case of a knife edge follower, the knife edge represents the trace point, whereas in roller follower, the center of the roller represents the trace point. Question number 1, explain CAM and follower. A CAM is a rotating machine element which gives reciprocating and or oscillating motion to the another element, that is known as a follower. The CAM and the follower have a line contact and constitute a higher pair. This belongs to higher pair. The CAMs are usually rotated at a uniform speed by a shaft, but the follower motion is predetermined and will be according to the shape and size of the CAM. The CAM and the follower is one of the simplest as well as one of the most important mechanism found in modern machinery today. The CAMs are widely used for operating the inlet and exhaust valves of internal combustion engine, that is automatic attachment of machineries, paper cutting machines, spinning and weaving textile machineries, and feed mechanisms of automatic lathes, etc. Friends, this figure shows the animation of CAM and follower. When the CAM rotates with a uniform speed, the follower, it reciprocates, and the motion of the follower that depends upon the shape of the CAM. Number 2, classify different types of CAMs. The first one is radial or disc CAM and the second one is cylindrical CAM. In radial CAMs, the follower reciprocates or oscillates in a direction perpendicular to the CAM axis. The CAM, as shown in the figure, are radial CAM. Second one is cylindrical CAM. In cylindrical CAMs, the follower reciprocates or oscillates in direction parallel to the CAM axis. The follower rides in a groove at its cylindrical surface, a cylindrical groove CAM with a reciprocating and an oscillating follower is as shown in the figure A and B respectively. Question number 3, describe the different types of followers. First one is a knife edge follower, second one is the roller follower, third one is the flat-faced follower, flat-faced or mushroom follower, and the fourth one is the spherical-faced follower. Knife edge follower, when the contacting end of the follower has a sharp knife edge. It is called knife edge follower as shown in the figure A. The contacting end of the follower has a sharp knife edge. And the second one is a roller follower. When the contacting end of the follower is a roller, it is called a roller follower. Third one is a flat faced mushroom follower. When the contacting end of the follower is a perfectly flat face, then it is called a flat faced follower. And the fourth one is a spherical faced follower. When the contacting end of the follower is of spherical shape, then it is called a spherical faced follower. Next, types of followers, that is according to the surface in contact. Then we have four types of follower. First one is knife edge follower, second one is the roller follower, third one is the flat follower, and the fourth one is the spherical follower. And the second classification is according to the type of follower motion, that is number one, translatory motion of the follower, and the second one is oscillatory motion of the follower. And the third classification of the follower is according to the line of the follower motion. First one is radial follower, and the second one is offset follower. Next, question number 5. Explain prime circle and pitch circle related to cam profile. First one is pitch circle. It is circle drawn from the center of the cam through the pitch points. Next, prime circle. It is the smallest circle that can be drawn from the center of the cam and tangent to the pitch curve. For a knife edge and a flat face follower, the prime circle and the base circle are identical. For a roller follower, the prime circle is a larger than the base circle by the radius of roller. Next, construct the displacement diagram for uniform velocity and simple harmonic motion of the follower. Since the follower moves with a uniform velocity during its rise and return stroke, therefore the slope of the displacement curve must be constant. In other words, AB1 and C1D must be straight line. A little consideration will show that the follower remains at a rest during the part of the cam rotation. The periods during which the follower remains at rest are known as dwell period, as shown in the figure by the line B1, C1 and DE. We see that the acceleration and the retardation of the follower at the beginning and at the end of each stroke is infinite. This is because of that the follower is required to start from rest and has to gain a velocity within no time. This is only possible if the acceleration or retardation at the beginning and at the end of each stroke is infinite. These conditions are, however, impracticable. Second one, construct the displacement and velocity diagram for simple harmonic motion. The step number one is the displacement diagram is as shown in the figure when the follower moves with a simple harmonic motion. First of all, draw a semicircle on the follower stroke as a diameter. Next, divide the semicircle into any number of even equal parts, usually 6. That is, semicircle, it has 180 degree divided by number of parts means 6 means 6, that is each division is equal to 30 degree. And name this one And next, divide the angular displacement of the cam during the out stroke and return stroke into the same number of equal parts. That is 6 parts. 6 parts. And number 4, the displacement diagram is obtained by projecting the points. Projecting the points. Next, number 3, construct the displacement and velocity diagram for uniform motion of the follower. This is the figure shows that is when the follower moves with a when the follower moves with construct the displacement and velocity when the follower moves with uniform velocity motion. Divide the angular displacement of the cam during the out stroke theta naught into any even number of equal parts, say 8, and draw vertical lines through these points as shown in the figure. Divide the stroke of the follower S into same number of equal parts. Join AA to intersect the vertical line through the point 1 at B. Similarly, obtain the other points C, D, etc. Now join these points to obtain the parabolic curve for the out stroke of the follower. Number 4, in the similar way as discussed above, the displacement diagram for the follower during a return stroke. Next, number 4, construct the displacement and velocity diagram for uniform acceleration and retardation. In this case of cam, this straight line is a stroke of the follower which is translating, and the circumference of the rolling circle is equal to the stroke, that is S of the follower. And therefore, the radius of the rolling circle S is equal to, that is, is S divided by 2 pi. The displacement diagram is drawn as discussed below. First one is draw a circle of radius S divided by 2 pi with A as center. Divide the circle into any number of equal even parts, say 6. Next, project these points horizontally on the vertical center line of the circle. These points are shown by A dash, B dash, like that. Divide the angular displacement of the cam during out stroke into the same number of equal parts as the circle is divided, and draw vertical lines through these points. Join AB, which intersects the vertical line through 3 dash at C. From A dash, draw a line parallel to AB intersecting the vertical lines through 1 dash and 2 dash at A and B respectively. Similarly, from B dash, draw a line parallel to AB intersecting the vertical lines through 4 dash and 5 dash and D and E respectively. Join the points capital A, small a, B, C, D, E, and capital B by a smooth curve. This is the required cycloid curve for the follower during out stroke. Next, problem number 1. A cam is to give the following motion for a knife edge follower. Knife edge for number 1, out stroke during that is theta naught is equal to 60 degree. Number 2, dwell for the theta d is equal to 30 degree. And number 3, return stroke theta r is equal to 60 degree rotation of time. And number 4, theta d is equal to next remaining 210 degree of cam rotation. The stroke of the follower is S is equal to 40 mm and the minimum radius of the cam minimum 50 mm. The follower moves with uniform velocity during both the out stroke and return stroke. Draw the profile of the cam there are two condition. When the axis of the follower that passes through the axis of the cam of the shaft, and the second condition is that when the axis of the follower is offset by 20 mm from the axis of them. First of all, that is when the axis of the follower that passes through the axis of the cam shaft, first of all we have to draw the displacement diagram as discussed previously. That is, here theta naught take a line OX, OX is equal to 360 degree, because one circle is equal to 360 degree. That is AX, take AX is equal to 360 degree, and on the x-axis, first of all mark theta naught is equal to 60 degree, theta d is equal to 30 degree, and theta r is also 60 degree. Divide the outer stroke and return stroke into 6 equal divisions, then name the different points 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for outer stroke, and for return stroke 0, 1, 0-1-2-3-4-5-6- for return stroke, not for dwell period. Similarly, on the vertical, on the y axis, take that is the stroke is equal to that is 40 mm. Now we have that is a rectangular block. Join all the points, that is draw the vertical projections from various points. Join A, G and H, P. We have A, B, capital A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P points. And this is the when the motion of the follower, when the follower moves with a uniform velocity. Next, how to draw the cam profile? First of all, draw a circle of minimum radius of the cam 50 mm radius. Draw a circle. Next, here when the cam that passes through the center of the follower axis that is here A is the starting point. Note down that one. That is, then on that circle, that is, measure theta O, that is equal to 60 degree, that is AS is equal to 60 degree, ST is equal to 30 degree, and TP is equal to 60 degree, and divide the outer stroke and return stroke into 6 equal divisions. Next, note this one, say, name the different points 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, for return stroke 0-1-2-3-4-5-6-. Then draw a line that is from various point to the center of the cam, vertical line. Draw vertical lines from various points to the center of the cam. Then mark, that is 0A, this is starting point, 1B, 2C, 3D, 4E, 5F, and 6G, similarly 0-H, 1-J, 2-K, 3-L, 4-M, 5 dash n and 6 dash p. Draw a smooth curve that passes through these various points. This is the profile of the cam. When the follower moves with a uniform velocity, when the follower axis that passes through the center of the cam. Similarly, when the axis of the same displacement diagram, here, first of all, draw a circle that is minimum radius of the cam 50 mm. Next, the offset circle is there, that is 20 mm. Draw one more circle, same center, offset, that is 20 mm diameter, 20 mm radius, draw a circle, 20 mm radius. And join a tangent from the offset circle to the this one minimum base circle, and then mark AS is equal to 60 degree, ST is equal to 30 degree, and TP is equal to 60 degree. Divide AS into 6 equal divisions and TP into 6 equal divisions. From various points 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash. Draw the tangent to the offset circle from various points. Tangents. Next, measure 0A, 1B, 2C, mark 3D, 4E, 5F, 5G, 6G, 6G, 0 dash H, 1 dash J, 2 dash K, 3 dash L, 4 dash M, 5 dash N, and 6P. And draw a smooth curve that passes through these various points, it is the cam profile when the axis of the follower is offset by 20 mm. Second problem, a cam with a minimum radius, this is the minimum radius of the cam 25 mm, rotating clockwise at a uniform speed, is to be designed to give a roller follower at the end of a wall rod motion described below. That is, S is equal to 50 mm and theta naught out stroke is 120 degree, theta d is equal to 30 degree, and theta r is equal to 60 degree. Next, theta d is equal to 150 degree. The diameter of the roller is 20 mm. The diameter of the camshaft is 25 mm. Draw the cam profile. When the line of stroke of the wall that passes through the axis of the cam, and the second condition is that the line of the stroke is offset 15 mm from the cam axis. The displacement of a wall while being raised and lowered is to take place with simple harmonic motion, that is, the motion of the follower is a simple harmonic motion. First of all, when the axis of the follower that passes through the center of the cam, we have to draw the displacement diagram. Draw a line that is AX is equal to 360 degree, and mark AS is equal to 120 degree, and ST is equal to 30 degree, and TP is equal to 60 degree. The remaining is 12 period. 12 period. And divide AS into 6 equal divisions and TS TP is equal to 6 equal divisions. And name the, that is different points, that is A1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly for return stroke 0 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, 6 dash. Next, the stroke is 50 mm. Draw a semicircle. Draw a semicircle of radius that is equal to the diameter of that one is 50 mm. Divide this semicircle into 6 equal divisions and each division is equal to 30 degree and name the different points that is small a, b, c, d, e, f, like that. Next, now draw the horizontal line and as well as vertical line and they meet each other and mark these points that is capital A, capital B, capital C, capital D, capital A, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. Similarly, join all these points by a smooth curve. Now, this is the displacement diagram when the follower moves with simple harmonic motion. Next, how to draw the cam profile with a roller follower. First of all, here, in the diaphragm follower, the minimum radius of the cam, whatever is given, that is the radius. But here, the minimum radius of the or base circle is equal to or prime circle is equal to minimum radius of the cam plus half the diameter of the roller. Then, that is equal to prime circle. Prime circle. Here, the first cam profile is when the axis of the follower that passes through the center of the cam. Now, here A is the starting point. Starting O, A. A is the starting point. And divide the, that is mark the prime circle. AS is equal to 120 degree, ST is equal to 30 degree and TP is equal to 60 degree. Divide AS into 6 equal divisions and TP is also divided into 6 equal divisions. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, 0 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash. And draw line from various points 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, to the center of the cam projection lines. Then mark A0, 1B, C2, C, 2C, 3D, 4F, 5G, 5F, 6G, 0 dash H, 1 dash, likewise, etc. From the displacement diagram. Displacement diagram. And from A, B, C, D, E, F, G, draw the minimum, that is the diameter of the, draw circles, that is the radius of the cam given. Next, join all the circles by drawing tangents to all roller circles by a smooth curve. This is the profile of the cam when the follower moves with simple harmonic motion and the motion of the follower is simple harmonic motion, that is when the axis of the cam that passes through the center of the cam. In the same way, next when the axis of the follower that is upset a circle. This is also same circle, same method, but here we have to draw the tangents from various points to the base, to the upset circle, to the